Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
You're most welcome, God's people, wherever you are. And I believe the reception is also where you are, please.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Also, I believe we all have our updates in our devices and our mail boxes, please.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right, you're welcome.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you once again for another opportunity in your presence today. Father, we appreciate your greatness. We appreciate this time out in your presence. Thank you, Father, because you're going to make your will known to us in a peculiar way today. Thank you, mighty Father, because your very spirit is going to confirm the truth of the gospel concerning Passover today. Mm-hmm. And thank you, Father, because by the time we are done in your presence, we all have every reason. Bless your holy name. To you be all the glory, all the honor,
amen,
and all the majesty.
Amen.
In Christ's mighty name, worship.
Amen.
Let all God's people, wherever you are, hearing that, amen, please.
Amen.
Amen.
You're almost welcome in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And once again, I believe the reception is awesome where you are, please.
Yes, sir.
Our social media is perfect. Okay. So please turn your scriptures to 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 8, please. And please, if you can see what I'm sharing on the screen, please do let me know. Second Corinthians chapter 13, verse 8. If you can see what I'm sharing on the screen, please do let me.
We can see. Thank you, sir.
All right, you're welcome.
I can see. Thanks.
You're welcome. So 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 6, it says, we can do nothing against the truth but for
the truth.
And I've told us what that means over and over. It's because the truth is life, is God, is everything's main entity. And I've told us what main entity stands for. It determines the nature of the outcome of that situation as well as the initiator. That is the reason why. Sisters, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I want to tell you, sisters, maybe consider today's service as your service. And I will tell you why. Today is one of those days that you come to remember the awesomeness of God. I really hope every sister under my shepherdship is hearing this. Because
yes, sir,
there are two major experiences that happened today. Not as if they shocked me, but you know, sometimes something happens and you are overwhelmed. You are overwhelmed about the awesomeness of God. And sisters, I want you to listen very well. I don't care your background. I don't care your issues. But let me tell you, you are blessed to hear this truth. You are blessed to to have somebody who's not going to tell you a lie about who you are. The first of the experience I had today, a great woman of God that I respect so much, who is married to also a fellow minister. They both have a thriving ministry. They didn't start ministry yesterday. They didn't get married today. In fact, their eldest child is her mid-20s. So that's to tell you that you're not talking, I'm not talking about people who are young couple who have not seen life. But I wished the over 2 hours conversation I had with this great woman of God was recorded. Not for the over, but for you sisters to hear. I'm not talking about an ordinary woman. Like I told you, this woman is a minister. She has her own ministry. It's just for privacy's sake, I can't tell you. But this is a public forum. She has her own ministry, thriving, successful ministry. And so is the husband. But should I tell you what this woman of God told me?
What's that?
And that is why she knew that she's a truth teller. That's a truth teller. In me. She said, without taking anything from her words, said, Reverend, is it possible that because of my marriage, I've destroyed my purpose in here? I didn't know when tears started rolling. Some of us are telling you this truth and it's like, you have issues with me. This is a woman that is successful. How to trust in the wisdom and strength of the Holy Spirit to be able to tell her that, yes, it is possible. And how to tell her the hard truth. She has to look and look at the glass half full, not half. Those wasted years to a springboard. What will they do? I could tell her all the truth that without privilege to hear, we out here. Tell her that as an adult, she's not too old to start all over again. I will tell her that Moses fulfilled his ministry at age 80. That if Moses can do it without Christ, she can put herself together. A woman, that's a coin, that's a superhero. I challenge you sisters hearing me. How many of you will be ready to take that kind of step? How many of you will be ready to come out? And let me tell you this. It's not as if they have a quarrel in their marriage. She just discovered that when you are a submissive woman, there's no way you can fulfill your purpose. It can't work. You have a life to live. Carefully, this woman had to ask, why didn't I yank her out when she reconnected with me 11 years ago? See, first of all, I'm a man, so I don't have the grace over a woman. See, two, I'm a minister. And the best I can do is what I've been doing, and I will always do. People of God, please listen. All of us are going to learn. What did I just say? Great people of God.
All of us are going to learn.
Don't believe what the word tells you that experience is the best teacher. This great woman, in her own words, wished she knew what I told her today. Almost 30 years ago, when she got married. Is what can prevent. Experience is only a cure. So it's a lie that experience is the best teacher. It's the worst teacher. Because you become a superhero with experience. It's not everybody that becomes superhero with experience. Some people that experience is the last experience. Some people the last experience they find themselves in hell. So why wait for experience? But as per, we're not going to learn. Everybody's going to learn. The scripture says every tongue, those who has gone, those who are yet to be born, all of us that are in the flesh now, every single tongue is going to confess that Jesus is. And every knee is going to bow to the truth. Even Satan that is deceiving us. The scripture says believes and trembles. Let me show you a scripture in Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10, people of God, let's go there. I want to show us something in verse 31. Okay, let me so I will understand what. Apostle Paul was talking here. Yeah. I read from verse 16. Thank God that today is even celebration of Passover. Christ is a Passover. So it's a celebration of Christ. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Well, like I've told us, it's Yahushua that lived and died. But guess who resurrected Christ? I've told you, Christ means your purpose. That is why when you get saved, one of the names we are called is Christ. Not Jesus. Christ. Christ. It's not God that calls all Christians. It's people that called new creations Christians. It wasn't God. What God calls us is Christ. And Christ means your purpose. Now see, from verse 6, this is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws in their heart, and in their minds I will write them. And their sins and iniquities will I remember no more. Now that is talking about all our sins and before we got saved. The reason for salvation, the reason why everybody needs to get saved, because once you become an adult, the sinful nature is going to revive. Courtesy of the fall of Adam. It's not God's fault, it's Adam's fault, but nothing you and I can do about it. And until you get saved, before you can experience what Adam and Eve experienced in the garden before they sinned. Which is not to have a pure heart. Of course, when you get saved, every of your sin, and that's why you are called a brand new creature. No matter the level of your sin, before you got saved, you are not the one that sinned it once you get saved. New creature in Christ Jesus. And that's what he's saying there. God says, your sin, my sin, and iniquity, he will remember no more. Now, look at verse 18. Now, where remission of this is, there is no more offering for sin. Like Christ is trying to say, yeah, because what he's trying to say here, that no need for all this religious thing, and it's still ridiculous. Because he says here, in verse, I say, having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. Why? Because Christ has bought all the offering. That's the purpose of Passover. How many people we are getting here?
Yes, sir.
Now look at verse 20. He said, by a new and living way, which he had consecrated for us, through the veil, that is to say, his flesh, and having an high priest over the house of God. Now look at it. He says, let us draw near with a true heart, in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience, and our bodies washed with pure water. This is talking about the ministry of the word. Let us hold fast to the profession of faith without wavering. You know, in this sentence, I've been talking about consistency. I've been talking about consistency. Listen to me. If you draw back in your righteousness, in your purpose, you are playing with fire. This truth I'm sharing with you, don't waste your life. Don't waste eternity. Don't wait until you miss heaven before you know I'm telling you the truth. Because then it is too late. There's nothing you can do then. Now that you are still breathing, now that you are still existing in this night, now that you are still in this house, now you can do something. But once you check out, it's too late. There's nothing you can do. Some of us will live and see we have an extra. Nobody has an extra life. I've told everyone of us, all of us are special to God. Stop believing you are special. You are not more than me, I'm not more than you. Some of you, because I'm the first person that will ever tell you that rise up, you are like everybody. You know, because you have been used to language of suppression. Because in your life, people have suppressed you. The only person you think you can suppress is not me that is telling you get up from your feet. Listen to me. I said it on Sunday. When I don't react to you, when you react to me, it's out of principle. Why? Because my lion, no matter how hungry, is not going to eat grass. Because you stop following me as I follow, you stop having faith in me, doesn't mean I will change what I believe in you. That's what is spoiling some of us. Because I will still say what I believe about you. Because that's the truth. Even though you don't believe it. I've told you, it won't work for you because you don't believe it. Not because I told you a lie. The reason why it's not working, because you don't believe it. But nobody is neutral. The moment you don't believe the truth, there's already a lie you're going to believe. The moment you stop following me, Pastor, because my word is not law. The moment I don't reflect an indication of the number one in your life, there's already somebody else who stood for life. None of us is neutral. None of us is stagnant. That is why if you're in right, you are improving. You are growing up. You are moving from glory to glory. And if you're in the negative, you are becoming worse. But somebody telling you are neutral, it's a lie. Nobody is neutral. Like now, as you listen to me now, you're either connecting with me or not. There's nothing like in between. I've told you I'm your pastor because what I tell you doesn't fall to come in vain. But if I'm not your pastor, no matter this truth I'm telling you, it won't work. Workability of things is by your faith. But the only difference, once it's not the truth, it will work, but it's going to work against you. And sisters, see an example. How many of you, in whatever success you think you are, can stand beside this great woman of God? This is a woman, if I'm to tell you, if your faith can handle your one-on-one, if you have, you would. She's a popular minister. Her husband is a minister. Yet, she saw that's an error. She saw that she's not fulfilling her purpose. Because she erroneously believed as a woman, no matter your grace, you should serve a man. See, after almost 30 years, thank God that it's never too late with the Heavenly Father. But must you wait till that? Must you wait till you suffer? Let's read on. Pastor, he said, let us offer the profession of faith without wavering, because he is faithful that promised. Look at verse 24. He said, let us consider one another to provoke unto love and to do good works. Some of us, we have become Satan tools. When you talk to people, it's to discourage them, to rebellion, to disobedience. When you do that, your life becomes darkness. If you love people, you tell them the truth. No matter who they are, whether they're your husband, they're your wife, they're your friend, they're your sister, they're your brother, they're your neighbor, no matter who they are, if you love people, you tell them the truth. If you love somebody, when you see them regressing, tell them you are regressing. Is it that you don't realize how serious life is? Life is not a game, it's a journey. And I've told you, once you are hearing me now, you can't disappear anywhere. Even if you leave this body, even if you take poison, you are still going to exist forever. The only difference is that what you are doing now, this thing I'm telling you now, in your eternity, you are going to exist either like an angel or like a demon. But you can't change once you check out. It's now that you can change. No matter how wrong you have been, you can change now as I'm talking and make up your life never to regress again. You can. Verse 25. He said, not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together. Sometimes I wonder with some of us that claiming I'm your pastor, yet you don't relate with people that share grace, that share gender. How many of you brothers relate with one another? Yes, I'm your pastor. I'm not. Because if I'm your pastor, you will find friends in fellow men like you who follow me as pastor. If you're a sister, you will find friends in fellow sister like you who follow me as I follow Christ. If you're married, you will find friends in couples that are also under my shepherdship. But the scripture says, iron sharpeneth iron. Not iron sharpeneth wood. Not iron sharpeneth copper. It's iron sharpening iron. I've told you, and listen to me, Lord God. There are things that are not happening to you. But it's not because you are doing that. It's because of my DNA in your life. But because nobody is neutral, if you are not careful, you will use your own hand to exude, to flush out my DNA in your life. And when that happens, you can't stop the disaster. Life is about loss. Things don't just happen. That's why some of us have gotten ourselves to a gray area. We started doing like the children of Israel. And let me tell you, with what I'm about to tell you next, I thought, when I talked with that great man of God for 2 solid hours, I thought that was it. I didn't know I'm still going to hear another awesomeness this afternoon. At that moment, this second experience weakened me. It's also, in fact, today is, like I said, sister, today is your day. Because today, what I learned it from 2 women of God, 2 female ministers. And this second one was mind-blowing. This afternoon, I thought I was sitting in the hall of the morning experience, because this first great woman of God, it was in the morning she called. In the afternoon, and I thank God they approached this woman. I think she knew how serious what she's about to say. She actually sent it as an audio message. In fact, it's something that even if I'm going to share it with my I won't be able to say it first unless I plead the ordeal. This woman of God sent an ordeal message to me. And guess what was there? She said a prophetic vision of somebody under my shepherdship. This is somebody this woman has never met. Never even know the detail, but got everything right. But the content of that message was serious. And these are things I've seen years before now about this person. I've tried to call family, friends, people who are close, this person. That, what is this person? Listen to me, life is about laws. Don't take things for granted. There are people that depend on you, just like there are people you depend on. When Apostle Paul met Christ before he got saved, in that vision, see what Christ told him. He said, it is hard for you to kick against the pricks. Life is about lost people. Let us wake up. Let's stop toiling with things. Let's stop toiling with things. There are sisters who are not old enough to even come out, don't even know who to call. Like that first woman that called. If she's not humble, she will not call. Because your relationship doesn't have value, doesn't mean it's right. The scripture says it's better you eat junk when there's righteousness, than to eat the best of meal. Yet, it's darkness that is there. Don't wait until you begin to reap consequences. There are people you can't disconnect from. It's too late. Once you meet such people, I've shown you the chart. As a man, if you have met a queen, it's too late for you. There's nothing you can do. It's only a woman that's not a queen you can toy with. But if your man is a queen, that's what you can do. But the highest, when you meet a faithful minister, there's nothing you can do. Try it, the consequences is terrible. Which is why you see me. I try to encourage you with my own examples. I try to encourage you with other people's example, both in the positive and in the negative. Just like I said on Sunday, when I give example of people doing that, you should go for the subject matter. What concerns you? Who is the person? Learn before it's too late. Learn before it's too late. There are people under my shepherdship who have benefited. There's a family years ago in the 90s. The particular sister that stayed under my shepherdship is the only, as I'm talking to you now, the only last born in a generation that is alive. All other last borns who are our first cousin. They're giving up the ghost. Because of the kind of curse that is on that family. There are things your niceness can never save you. It's only your righteousness. That's why Christ is our Passover. Your practical Passover is your purpose. That's the only time evil, negativity can pass you over. This be checking out. My end to the centers and drop you home after the Lord. Let's check them. Please. How was I kept? My God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is I should. Everyone can hear me very well now, please.
Yes, sir.
So once again, if you can see what I'm sharing, please do let me.
Yes, sir. You can
see, thank you, sir. Right, you're welcome. So let's read on. Verse 25 now says, not forsaking the gathering together, as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, so much the more as you see the day approaching. Verse 26. He's getting. He said, "For if we what
sin willfully,
sin willfully. If we sin willfully, there's remained
no what? More sacrifice.
No more." Sacrifice for sin. People of God, let's be careful. Even though I've been teaching, but with those two experiences, you've got this second woman of God. After listening to the gospel message, and I called her. When she asked me, did I get her? I said, yes. I said, that's why I'm calling. I told her, I said, if she has ever been to this city, I would have said, that's where. Got any information? If there's a way she's met people concerned, I would have said, somebody said, told her, said she's totally on point. I said, what exactly she saw is what I'd seen years before now. Years before now. And that over the matter, I've almost become like an enemy. Because almost becoming what's your own. Listen to me, people of God. The scripture says it's not God's will that any of us should perish. But you know the other side. God can't do anything about it if you choose to perish. There's nothing God can do about it. That's why to stop believing all this nonsense that is flying about. What God cannot do doesn't exist. That's the latest deception from the pit of hell. And some of you, you say, I'm your pastor, you are sharing and believing such a thing. How does that make sense? Can God lie?
No.
Somebody answer me.
No, sir.
Can God fail?
No, sir.
Isn't failure in existence?
It is.
Isn't lies in existence?
It is.
Yet somebody is telling you what God cannot do. Doesn't you two, you are sharing it. And you say you are not worshiping Satan. You say faithful ministers like me are your pastor. Says who? Who day did you hear that insult to God? In my mouth. You are told the truth. To study the truth. To embrace the truth. What's some of the sentences here? Now, look at verse 27. It said, but a certain fearful looking for of judgment and fearing nation, which had devoured the adversaries. Apostle was now started making comparison. He said, he that despised Moses' law. Look at that. The Old Testament of Moses, it is a God's law. He said, they died without mercy under two or three witnesses. Look at verse 29. Of much more solar punishment, suppose you, shall he be thought worthy, who are trodden under the foot, the Son of God. That is, you put Christ, you put your purpose under your feet, and you counted the blood of covenant by which you are sanctified and a holy thing, and are done despite unto the Spirit of grace. Verse 30. For we know him that said, vengeance belong to me, I will repay, said the Lord. And again, the Lord that judge his people. In fact, one of our quotes talks about this in an hilarious fashion. This quote is courtesy of Pastor Flourish. I hope you're seeing what I'm sharing on your screen, please.
Yes, sir.
From two different systems. You mean the brethren here said they are not seeing what the other centers are seeing. You come out of that and add to your word.
Because I'm not connected. It's not online.
I'm since you like.
It's not the same.
It's quickly so that we can proceed. What is supposed to be to assistance. Not in their back, please. Please, if you can see what I'm sharing on your screen, please do let me know, please. All right. You're welcome. So, we were on Hebrews 12.
10.
Sorry, Hebrews 10. And one verse 30, which says, "For we know him, he had said, vengeance belong to him, and I will recompense, saith the Lord." Recompense means I will reward. And again, he said, "The Lord has judged his people." And I said, there's a quote from Pastor Flourish that speaks to this. And I hope we can see this quote on our screen.
Yes,
sir.
Even though it's an hilarious word, but there's a whole lot of truth inside. Now, this is for people that want to take loss into their own hands. Now, listen to me, people of God. Because your pastor here will never take loss into his own hands, doesn't mean actions don't have consequences. Learn from the experience that I've just shared with you. But when I woke up this morning, if somebody had told me that I will be overwhelmed with the awesomeness of God, courtesy of these two women ministers, I would have been shocked. But you see, I'm encouraged that the first woman count me worthy, believing that I'm going to tell her the truth. Even though she discovered it by experience after years. And the second one, I'm also encouraged in the sense that it's not like, oh, I'm making things up. Like a mother, you see mothers, when they see injury, disaster ahead of their children, they will do everything to prevent that child.
That's true.
But do you know at that moment the child sees them as an enemy? The child sees them, this woman doesn't want to enjoy my life. But the woman already sees destruction ahead. Now see what Pastor Flores says here. For those who hear. It shouldn't be because people take loss to their hands that's right. Rebellion unto is also right. It is not. What it belongs to you? Why are you touching what is not yours by trying to revenge the offenses of people towards you? Life is about loss, people. The reason why Christ in Matthew chapter 5, verse 44 says, "Love your enemies, for them that despitefully use your power, so you will not have blood in your hands." Then you don't have blood in your hands. But that you see people who have faith in you, you take advantage of them, there's consequence. I always tell people, Ananias and Sapphira, Christ died for them on the cross too.
That's true.
But they took things for granted. They forgot that all of us are a product. forgot there are things you don't say no to and there are things you don't say yes to. They forgot there are people you don't have attitude against. They forgot there are people you don't embrace. In fact, after that encounter, I looked up into heaven and I told God, I said, from today onwards, that heaven grant me quest. That anywhere, anyhow, that anyone gets on this truth, wherever they may be, let there be mega justification. And anyone, but the scripture says it is impossible that pass me, but wanting through it cometh. And anyone, except take advantage of people to these truths, let them start reaping what they sow. So that people will know there is God. That's what Apostle Paul was saying here. And this of Moses, people don't try it. How much more now? That's why he said it's a fearful thing. There's another quote of reference here. I call this quote Rebellion Truth. Yes, this is it. Courtesy of Sister Timmy O'Keefe. Sadly, some of us are beginning to get into this. They say some people miss the message. They are too busy looking for mistake. The scripture that we always should never say, for you can do nothing against me. It's not about me. It's about the truth. Because I'm telling everybody the truth, that's why it looks like it's not about me. It's about me. Even me, I cannot do anything against the truth. That is why 1 Corinthians 14:38, Apostle Paul said, when people choose to remain ignorant, we should allow them to be ignorant. But that, under this ministry of truth, somebody will want to gang up against the interests of people who do their connection, they will have heaven to face, not me. But truth can defend itself. Truth has a life of its own. Truth is undefeatable. But life is about the truth. Help God's people. Please bless us. Please.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Now, relative to this truth, let me tell us something. There's this saying that you normally hear in the world. I'm going to our update for today now. There's this saying you normally hear in the world, and I want to tell you, people of God, on the authority of God's word today, that statement is a fact but not the truth. Now, what is the statement? The statement says that if we are still all this in place.
Yes, sir.
This statement is if you have something, let it go. That if it comes back to you, it's meant to be yours. But if he never comes back, it was never meant to be yours. I believe all of us have had that statement one time or the other, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I want to tell you, people of God, that statement is a fact, but not the truth. What does that mean? It's partially true. And let me tell you where it is true. It is true for female entities, but it's not true for male entities. The second case where it is true is when you are relating with people that has a higher grace. If you let go of the right female in your life, you have committed suicide. If you, a man, you are blessed to come in contact with a queen, let's listen very well. The statement normally says, if you have something, let it go. If it comes back to you, it's meant to be yours. If it didn't come back, it's never meant to be yours. I told you, it's a fact, not the truth. Because it's not 100% true. And I told you that the only two cases that it is the truth is relative to female entity. And I'm certainly giving the example. If you, a man is a male entity in marriage. A flock is a male entity when it comes to the local church. If you, a man, meet a queen and you don't cut her and you let her go in the name of, listen to me, you have simply committed suicide. Another queen, you cannot even find because you won't connect. You can't despise Queen A and find Queen B. That statement is only true for a female entity. As a queen, you don't send a man. So many times, sisters, you fail to realize who a queen is. Listen to me, sisters. A queen protects. A queen advise, and a queen influence any man that comes. Did I mention their husband there?
No, sir.
It's a man. It's a man that determines his wife. You cannot determine that man. Any man, no matter who they are, that's what makes you a queen. The moment you addict yourself, learn from that. See, I wish I could tell you, this woman is a popular minister who has accomplished, yet she has seen that there was a fatal error because she was in a submissive marriage. She has our ministry, so I see the ministry has gone down. She saw that never fulfilled her purpose. Even though she was a minister. Despite they have 5 children, of which 3 are adults, graduates. We're not talking about people who have not accomplished. You have still tried to accomplish. You are sitting and talking tops. Don't wait until you learn bitterly. 2 solid hours. 2 hours. Sat down. Listen carefully to this woman. Sisters, that statement is for you, but brothers, it's not for you. Don't try to take on. If you are blessed, it's a blessing to meet a queen as a man. And you don't connect. You don't tap into her in the name of, if something you're letting go. You have committed suicide. And sister, how do you be a queen? Queen, don't ask questions. Let the advice and influence any man, not a particular man, as long as the man comes under their influence, under their umbrella. They do the same. But guess what they don't do?
What?
They don't defend the man. Queens never defend the man, the man's action. They don't explain for the man. That is your job as a man. If a woman is yours, you will defend her. If a woman is yours, you will explain for her. I keep on telling you, sisters, don't wait until you learn this lesson bitterly. Don't wait until you have blood in your hands. And let me tell you, if you add the truth, it's too late. I've shared with you many months ago that is when you have not met the truth, that as a slave, you die for the beast or the controller in your life. But once you meet the truth, those beasts in your life will go forth so that you can have opportunity that you want to be an Abigail. It's not only Sapphira that had a controlling husband. Abigail too did. But guess what? Abigail, when he heard that this man, out of his ego, out of his pride, had that attack, she didn't pause. That's a queen. She didn't pause. How many women now can do that? You think people will not talk to her?
Yeah.
Some people will not even believe that the guy, neighbor, had that attack and died out of his ownership of the wife. You know what they will believe? Some people will believe it's David that killed him again. Wow. Because of what has happened with Uriah. It's not that people twist story. People have been twisting story from the day Adam twisted story, the woman you gave me. People have been twisting story. People would have said that, but you see, Abigail stood because she understood this principle. That you are here for purpose. But look at Sapphira. Despite the fact that Ananias, she chose to die, can you be that rebellious? If you are going to die, die for your maker. Christ said, any of these things in life that you, because of it, turn your back on your purpose. He said, you are still going to lose that thing. He said, but if you don't allow those things to slow you down, he said, that is when you will discover those things big time. You want to tell me a woman that has married for almost 30 years, have five great lives in between them, now woke up to the reality that there was error? You think she is him? Huh? You think Satan has entered her?
No.
That's what I'm telling you, God. Everybody's going to lie. Everybody. But it's better you learn by instruction. Like I tell you, I'm a very passionate person, but don't mistake my passion for sentiments. It's my passion that will make me to still tell you the truth, even if you don't want to hear it. You know why? So that when the consequences come, you can't face me and tell God, this man didn't tell me that you watch out. That's why I'm doing this. As long as none of you can face me when the consequences come, that's why I'm doing this. But that's the only time your blood will be on my head that I did not tell you. But the fact that I've told you minimum of 3 times that as a woman you carry a higher grace, that as a woman you are not here for a man. When we read Proverbs 31, even though it says the husband of a virtuous woman is known in the gates, that scripture never mentioned anything she did for him. What you see there is what she did for her career, for her purpose, for her children, but not for the guy. The grace on you, like I said, is to protect a man that comes under your umbrella, is to advise, is to influence, but not to defend, not to serve, not to go after. Look at the first woman. Did Eve ever say anything?
No.
Nothing. Nothing, and absolutely nothing. And I keep on telling you, brothers, keep on enjoying the submissive woman. There's nothing you can do. You are a man forever. Leave this body. You are still a man. There's nothing you can do. No matter how much you are blessed today, for a woman, I've told you, you'll be blessed. But it's not divine blessing. And your life will end in sorrow. That's the truth. That statement also is not true spiritually for you, the flock. Once you have met a faithful minister, if you ever let go of a faithful minister that committed suicide, that is it. It's about lost people. And based on that statement, I said it's not the truth, just a fact. Because it only works for female entity and for higher grace entity. It's a saved person that can let go of an unsaved person. Are you with me?
Yeah.
And if that unsaved person is meant to be in your life, to come back. It's a woman that can let go of a man. If you are meant to be with a man, you will come back. It's a pastor like me. See, let me tell you this. I said on Sunday, things that you can do wrong, yet it will be working for you. Like when you are a woman, you change your religion, you change your life, you change your base, you change. It will work if that your husband has a faithful minister like me. It will work for you. But not that you did what is right. Let me tell you, some of you, the relationship you have with me is not right. But it's working for you. That what you think is right. You know why it's not right?
Why is that?
Because I'm the one sustaining the relationship. If yet any of you hear me now, and I'm the one into you, you are not into me, you are in danger. Because you cannot prove I'm your pastor. Because I'm the one into you. Your pastor is a female entity. It's the male that is into. That is why I cannot, no matter how much I want to be your pastor, if I'm your pastor as I'm talking, and you made that possible. You are the one that my words does not drop to the ground in vain. But just like women, a woman is a queen. If you despise a woman that's a queen as a man that committed suicide, nobody can help you. If you are not reaping now, I've told you why. Maybe you have a mother who happens to be a queen. Your mother will not be alive forever. Maybe that queen that you despise still has children who are not yet adults. When they become adults one day, that's when disaster will come to you. Maybe you are under, though it's difficult to be under the shepherdship of a faithful minister and despise a queen. It's not possible. You a woman, and you cannot say a faithful minister is your pastor, yet you are domineering or submissive. It can work. It's not possible. Because light and darkness don't mix. The scripture says you can't serve two masters. You hate one and embrace the other. So if you are like that, you have despised the queen and nothing has happened, the reason why it has not happened, go and check it. Either that queen, there's something going on. Maybe you are still married, you're having sexual fellowship, there's something, or she has children for you that are not yet adults. You are at her mercy, even though you have despised her, even though she's not your wife here. Or your own mom, who's a queen, is still alive and well. Or there's a faithful minister. Or if both of you are not saved, there's somebody that you're beneficial who is saved. But that none of those things is there. It doesn't even happen. There's nothing like telling you you're a liar. It is not true. You will live. Life is about loss. And the same on the highest level. You can never go and study online episodes. See what Apostle Paul said happened to all that despised. He didn't have to do anything. against our laws. He didn't have to do anything. He didn't have to do anything. And that's what this Hebrew thing are talking about. And based on this, especially these two experiences I had today, especially the second one, it's as if this woman minister knew. That's why she left it on an audio message. She knew how. And see, our Heavenly Father is awesome. You know what I got from that second experience? That means that God truly says He doesn't want anybody to perish. For God to send a woman who has never met the people in this situation to say it exactly the way it is, it shows that God cares for every one of us. It's just sad that we don't care for ourselves. It's just sad that we don't love ourselves. But see, based on what I've shared with you and today's experience, I see God knew that this is what I wanted to share. And definitely this is the mind of God. That is why we have an update today on Adam, which is the practical adult humans. Now, before today, what you have on your right, which is the previous chart, is 10 categories. Are you seeing 5 in the positive and 5 in the negative? Negative means people that don't have light. 100% light. Okay?
Okay.
They might have a form of light. A form of light is still darkness. I've told you that. But the 5 that you see positive sign, they are all 100% light. But these are the levels of the light. Okay? But see, because of what I've just shared with you, I discovered there's a group. We had this group before, but it's overrated. And that's the group of the confused. Remember what Christ said, he said here to the Laodicean church, Revelation 3. Your study, please read it. He said he appreciate their works and all. He said, but he has something against them. He said they have lost their first love. He said they are neither hot nor cold. Let me tell you, that is the group that you see. It's a middle group. Let me tell you, that group you never want to be there. Because when you are in that group, you are at the mercy of being wasted by Satan. God, no protection. No matter the good you are doing. Because when you do good, you use your own hand to operate it. Can a plant grow after you plant the seed? The next day you come, uproot the seed to see whether it's growing. Will the seed ever grow?
No, sir.
That is why people in that group, they are not useful for everyone. Satan can use you. So people in that group, Satan wastes them. People in darkness will use you. Because they are darkness. You are neither hot nor cold. That's why Christ said, I would rather prefer you to be hot or cold, but not in between. But you will see that in the light for the updated and the corrected chart, there are still 5 groups. And you see that, people of God? Can we see that, people of God, please?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
And you will see a group that wasn't there before that has replaced the confused. The confused are not people of light. It's not anywhere you want to be. It's anywhere you want to be. It's not an acceptable at all. The acceptable is not the careless, the victim, and what I call the returnees. Who is a returnee? The prodigal son is a returnee. Returnees are people like Christ, Hebrews chapter 5, that even though he was the son of God, he learned obedience to through the things which he suffered. These are people who come back to doing the needful, what their eyes have seen, because they have chosen. You know, they are the lowest in light. Because if they did chop cake, they won't come back. If the negativity worked for them, they won't come back. This is why they are the lowest of light. But you see, the is still worse than them. That's why even in the Old Testament, he said, "Thou shalt not sow mingled seed." You see, a lot of men do this. You are in danger. Why must you increase the one? If you are not interested, let her go. You say you are married, you are married the woman, you have not signed the legal, at least that is the most secured. Registry wedding is more secured than any nonsense church wedding or any traditional wedding, which is just means of control. And it's registry wedding that gives. Now, obviously, sisters, you are listening to me.
Yes, sir.
And brothers, if you have not gone to court with that woman, you are a beast. You are evil. Let her go. Because it's only the Lord that can protect her.
Mm-hmm.
If anything, that is being confused. Sisters, if you are in that situation, I speak to your heart and be strong and walk away. Don't destroy your life. Learn from that great woman of God's testimony. Don't wait until your marriage is also over, when your children are adults, before you learn that your youthful years is all gone. Don't wait. Prevention, they say, is better than cure. Even though your generation is higher, are you going to be alive in the solution? So even when you're returning, you are still returning is the prodigal son. Go and study the story. That's why the brother who never left the father, which is the case of Aniro, is much higher than him. Because the prodigal son, if not that, he saw his living standard had gone down, he will not come back. He's a returning superhero. But who are superheroes? Superheroes are people. They go through their stuff, but they've entered into rest their purpose. That's why I can declare before you that this your pastor is a superhero. Why? Because when I came back after the 13 silent years, it's never to go back again. That's why the fire in me is more than the fire of the initial 7 years plus the 37 years put together. I'm talking forever. Even in my sleep, I will preach the truth. Let me tell you, all of us have that. That's why on the negative side, on the darkness side, the equivalent of superheroes are crabs. Crabs are people who are dogging in unrighteousness. Even God can't change them. Life is about consequences, people. So, because today is Passover, let me just say what Passover is. Passover is not passing people over or people passing over you. When it was instituted, it was death. Okay? That was supposed to pass over the children of Israel using the blood of the Lamb. And 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7, he said, Christ is our Passover Lamb. It is a Jesus. It's a Christ. What does that mean? Listen to me. Death is consequences of sin. When you make a blunder, there is a level of murder, a level of suicide that becomes your portion. But life is about consequence. But should I tell you the truth?
Yes, sir.
Stay in your purpose. That mercy will pass you over. That's what Passover is all about. Should I tell you the truth? Should I tell you something?
Yes, sir.
No matter how much I've bungled, no matter what I've done, even if it's as, even if possible, as much as I have blood in my hands, can I tell you the truth?
Yes, sir.
The consequence of that myself will pass over as long as I'm preaching the truth in season, out of season. That's what Passover is all about, people of God. Because Christ is about your, Christ means your purpose. That is why the scripture says all of God's will is twofold. For all of us to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. And your primary truth, the primary truth, the number one truth in your life, why are you here? Even though I might be careless in fulfilling my purpose, even when you are careless, see how high you are still. You're still much higher. And even people don't know what they are doing, the victims who have been taken advantage of. But you just be stained. Not as if darkness takes you over. Light. Your purpose is something you should never. Don't wait. Until consequence. Don't. Fine. There's place for returning, but it's the lowest place. And if you are confused now, stop being. Come out of it. In fact, face darkness than to be confused. Because after a while, you will lose your sense of judgment. That's what happened to the children of Israel in the days of Elijah. Go and read it. Go and read 1 Kings chapter 18. Do you know the children of Israel? Anytime disaster happened, do you know what they are blaming? They are blaming God. Or anytime they prosper, guess who they were going to give offering to? Baal. Was there Elijah spoke of that enough is enough? That the God that answers by fire, let him be God. That's what happens when you are mixed up. It's your enemy you will thank, and your savior you will turn against. You are confused. And what leads to confusion is when you want to sow mingle seed. That's what the scripture says. People of the kingdom, when you make up your mind, you don't look back. The scripture says any of us that put a hand on the plow and look back is not fit for the kingdom. You can't make it. The natural version of that is what is worth doing at all is worth doing well. It's worth doing best. Christ never said you're not going to have challenge. But let me tell you, all of us have it in us to have challenge. Let me show you a quote that talks about how all of us can handle challenges. And also tell you how God do justify and glorify. Before I show you that one, I just saw this one from Pastor Flores. I call this one truth. This is actually what life warfare is about. See the truth. Dr. Flores, he said the war going on is the war over truth. And the battlefield is the everybody on earth. This is the scriptures. This is 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3 to 5. You are not fighting with me, I'm not fighting with you, I'm not fighting with the human enemy. You are what you think, I am what I think. Our emotions don't manifest it. If you are defeated today, the defeat started in your mind. If you are victorious today, the victory started in your mind. Everything always starts. That is why Holy Spirit and Satan, they are both fighting over your mind. If you are messed up today, it started with a thought. And if you are entered less into your purpose, it started with a thought. Those 30 silent years of mine started with a thought. Now, the superheroes, 18 years and counting, also started with a thought. See another one, But I call this superheroes fact. I'll tell you why. Dr. Floyd says, he said, I'm more concerned about offending God than I am about offending people. Now, this is a fact because it's spiritual, and I will tell you why. Because all of us are image and glory of God. Should I tell you the truth? Whatever you value as God in your life, at every point in time, you are more concerned about offending that thing than offending people. That's why you see women who have made married God, they are more concerned about offending the beast called husband. But they don't care, they can even insult God Almighty. But they are concerned about offending the man. You now see why God says, you do not share his glory with anyone. So if today you think it's God, it's your choice. The only reason why you're a superhero is because you are more concerned about offending your maker. And the only time that is true is when you are primarily concerned about not fulfilling your purpose. Which is why I respected that first one of God. Obviously, fulfilling that purpose is number one. That is why successful marriage, successful ministry, twice secondary. She understood that fulfilling her purpose is primary. In fact, I told this great woman, I said, I envy all her five children. You know why? The kind of prosperity that will come to those five children, those children say, will not know where it's coming from. They won't know it's coming from the decision of their mom, who decided to be respect what she had to. And then quickly, this is another one I lost. I just have justification. Listen to me. When God to eat your call, eat your pulse, it will justify you. And it will glorify you. You don't have to try to explain things to people. Once it's the truth, justification is going to come. Once it's the truth, glorification is going to come. And let me tell you this. Whatever it is you are struggling over this truth I'm sharing with you, those Dagon that want to confuse you, persecuting you for this truth, they're going to fall flat in your face.
Amen.
So that you will not be able to choose, do you want to go with them or do you fulfill your purpose while you are here? Or that they are not going to fall down before you. You can't stop it. Because nobody can do anything against the truth. You see, if I'm not telling you the truth, that this is what happened. Look at this example. It's started when your joke backfires and you accidentally advances a woman's right. In 1887, a group of men added a woman named Susanna Sultan to a mayoral ballot, that is, ballot to elect a mayor, as a joke intended to humiliate women. Instead, she won over 60% of the vote and became America's first female mayor.
Wow.
You see justification?
Yes, sir.
You know, this is scriptural. That the pit, people have issues with. Because of your stand with the truth, dig for you, they will fall by themselves. Because everybody lives. But if it's not your purpose that God called, you don't expect justification. I don't expect glorification. But once it's the truth, once it's your purpose, justification is going to come. Too. I call this hilarious life truth. You see, a deer running for his life, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Being chased by by a lion. Is that not what you're saying?
Yes, sir.
And I like this. He said your follower is not always your fan.
That's true. You've
got people that want to devour you. People that want, they will also follow you. I hope sisters, you are. Some men will come to you to destroy you. Not as if they want you as their wife figure. That's why when you agree for them, your freedom is gone. Your zeal is gone. Your faith is gone. This is an example. And if you're a minister like me, it's not anybody that's crazy over you. There are some, they want to put you under their armpits. There's a case like that. I said, my somebody with an epistle of I should render help. Just before somebody let me of the help. I said, okay, that is starting point. Recipient of the service of the team. You know, immediately, this man removed herself from the room. My prophet here is a witness. Meanwhile, there's another woman. And this one didn't even have any of you. You know, this other woman did also. You now want to think that our maker will leave that one an embracer of truth and go out of his way to bless the one that despise that all is bad. Even when people came to Christ, the next after they were fed, did Christ feed them again?
No.
He didn't feed them and he didn't teach them. That's the part of Christ I'm going, I'm learning now. With the two experiences today, I'm learning that not only when I see that it's bread you are looking for, I will also feed you. Because I'm not your pastor. If I'm your pastor, it's the truth that will draw you. What will make you to ask for me is because I will tell you the truth. In fact, today, that first woman, I made up my mind, it's an appreciation. You know why?
Right.
Because when the woman said, she knows I will tell her the truth about this matter, I felt so humbled. I want to tell you about such a man's pastor. You know, it's an honor to be a minister. It's a great honor. I felt so humbled. Why would I leave someone at a critical decision like that, trusting me to tell her the truth? And I'll not be pursuing somebody. Even God will come to me and I will draw near unto you. So God's people, let's remember what Passover is again. It means death, which is every negativity, which comes as a result of sin passing us over. We can only pass over because Christ has become our Passover and Christ is our purpose. Once you fulfill your purpose, no evil can befall you. It's not possible. If at all anything can happen, you can only be stayed, maybe out of carelessness. But the evil will be for you. And you are fulfilling your purpose. It can never happen. But no matter evil that people plan for you, as long as you are fulfilling your purpose, you are going to rise. This is an hilarious and interesting. Tomorrow is April 4th. April 4th, they always say April Fool's Day. So in 1976, BBC, British Cooperative Corporation, convinced many listeners that a special alignment of planets would temporarily decrease gravity on Earth. Phone lines were flooded with callers who claimed they felt the effect, yet it was a lie. This is what I always say, that it's your faith that is making things to work. This is a radio station in 1970 who decided to play joke on the listeners. And people started calling that they felt the effect. You see why? You see what I've been telling you is not working because you didn't believe it. And that lie you believed, the reason why it's working is because you believed it. But guess what? Because it's a lie, give it time. But time is one of the things we can't do anything against. That lie is going to work against you. It's going to work again because you believe in it. If you didn't believe it, it won't work against you. But the workability of both truth or lie is your faith. It's your faith. That is why when you see you being a slave to another human being, the reason why that person is prospering, you cannot prosper. Because you have used your faith to say you are under and lesser than this person. That is why. That is why. Your faith makes things to work. I love this. This is for me. This is for every one of you out there. If you faith with this, it says hilarious connection to it. What's your sister Thomas? He says, don't be fooled with 5,000 followership on social media. Jesus only had 12 disciples, and yet he was still betrayed by one. I love this one. So learn to be your own person, okay?
Okay, sir.
Learn to be your own person. Wow. This one too says, we are not giving a good life or prayer. This is about faith again. We are giving a life. It is up to you to make it good or bad. So I believe we have been blessed today.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Friday, they call it Friday. I wonder which Friday is bad. If your Friday is bad, it's because you choose to see it bad, okay?
Okay.
Like I told us on Sunday.
Okay, sir.
It's on the Wednesday like this that Christ was crucified. Okay?
Okay, sir.
And even to tomorrow, the feast of Passover will only always start on the Wednesday. Which shows that they themselves, who are telling the lie with one hand, they are saying the truth with the other hand. So the person is going to be a public holiday to have service, but it's not going to be 6 p.m., it's going to be 2 o'clock on Friday. How we all got that place.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
But,
yes, sir.
And what you are going to tell, we're going to talk about death. There's a positive side of death. Before Christ, there was no positive side of death. Every side of death was negative. Okay?
Okay.
But you see, with Christ, there's a positive side of death. And what's the positive side of death? Resurrection. You cannot resurrect in an area that you have not died. And you cannot die unless you mess up. So even if you have messed up, as I'm talking, Friday is your day to see the positive side of death, which we see in John chapter 12, verse 24. So God willing, on Friday, we'll be here 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And for all of us, some of our people are celebrating their arrival day today. Happy arrival day. We show that you are special people to arrive on the day that Passover is being celebrated. So stay blessed, God's people. Stay raptured. We'll all see you on Friday, 2 o'clock. The afternoon Nigeria time.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome.
Thank you, sir.